Exciting to see the consumer enthusiasm, the retail enthusiasm, and just when people experience this product, it's something that they've never seen before and never experienced before, and it's really capturing the minds and attention of consumers and retailers everywhere. So we're really excited about the holiday coming up.
We can see Lori playing the game here in our studios. One of the other exciting things about it is how it's voice recognition.
Yeah.
I think that's certainly some technology. It's a technology that we talk about all the time, but putting it in practice is a little bit more difficult.
Well, absolutely. I mean, when you've seen major technological advances in the past where you've been able to unlock new consumer segments, it's usually when you bring down barriers between the technology and whatever experience you want. So whether it's a mouse and graphical user interface with a PC or touch in phones, we really believe in natural user interface, using your body, using your voice to control those experiences. And it makes it accessible, our Xbox Live service, being able to watch live games without getting off your couch, being able to control which games you're watching and what you're watching. It's a very powerful consumer scenario, so we're very excited.
A couple of years ago, we were talking about Nintendo Wii with a dominant position in your industry. Now, all of a sudden, Sony has caught up. You guys have caught up, and with this, now it seems like you've taken the lead in terms of the leading technology. What happened with the Wii, and what lessons can...
It's really been a collaboration across Microsoft. And so we've been bringing that into and leveraging that for the benefit of us and for the other parts of our business. We think this is natural user interface and using your voice and your body is a...
Get out. Lori just did.
Yeah, it was fun stuff. Not bad in high heels, right? That was impressive. All right.
Exciting. Some huge jumbo jetliners. All right. If you're worried about airline safety, why not just run to your next destination? That's what thousands will be doing this Sunday when the ING New York City Marathon takes place. Marathon organizers say the down economy won't slow down the amount of money it will bring in. They're expecting about $1 million sponsorship dollars for every mile.
How is the New York City Marathon able to bring in these big bucks? Joining us now is Cooper. So, Anne, let me start with you. With the crummy economy, soft ad revenue dollars, how is it that the marathon is still generating such strong dollars?
I think what we're talking to me yesterday, Imani, that as a receiver, you ran short distances very quickly.
Yeah.
So explain how you're turning into a long, or how you've trained into a long distance runner.
Well, the
I think it's the human spirit and the accomplishment. When you go out there on Sunday, you'll have two
exciting marathon and for a television broadcast. I know you also have a Chilean miner participating
the
marathon. So you must have an Imani story. So many interesting vignettes, interesting individual stories to keep those viewers tuned in, again, to generate those advertising dollars.
And contemporaries, you know, try
to be a little stretch.
Thanks, y'all. We certainly do appreciate it.
Thank you.
Outstanding.
Ann Wells Crandall, Executive Vice President for the New York City Roadrunners, and Imani Toomer, the former New York Giant, and a skilled player, right? That's how they would describe you as a receiver, right?
I like to say that.
Listen to Lori.
I like it when I impress you. All right. Up next, we go from New York on over to California.